I also think the narrative's interesting too, right? Like, you leave the division in the UFC, they were going to get rid of that flyweight division, and then this Brazilian monster comes out of nowhere, and the division's kind of back. And I know for me, it's like, God, I'd love to see Mighty Mouse take him out. You know what I'm saying? Like, God, let's see him jump back and just take his ass out, you know? Or you leave, and it creates a window for Henry Cejudo. It's like, he's the greatest of all time. Like, well, we just saw Mighty Mouse, like, beat him in, like, what, how fast was it? You know, the first fight.
Oh,
like,
first fight. Yeah. It was 2 minutes, 37 seconds. I was playing video games, and I was like, hey, guys, I'll be right back. I'm going to go across the street and go fight him. And I came back. I was, hey, guys, I'm back. And they're like, you was just on TV, and now you're back playing video games. I'm like, yeah, it was real quick.
It was real quick. It was a knee to the stomach. Yeah. So you, like, kind of left this path, and then this Figueredo comes in, and, you know, the talk, especially online, is like, God, I'd love to see how Demetrius Johnson would do against him, you know?
Yeah, I mean,
did you see any of that, or you guys not pay attention to that?
I mean, I don't pay attention, but I've seen him. He's a great athlete, big for the 125.
Fucking savage,
He
right?
fight at 135, too. Has a lot of power, great grappler, too. The last fight between him and Brandon Moreno was phenomenal.
One of the best fights of the year.
And, you know, I think, you know, I would love to see Henry Cejudo get back in there, and because I think,
me too.
You know, there's different levels. There's levels to this game, right? And Henry Cejudo, he's a competitor, right? And I mean, obviously, I've shared, you know, the cage with him on two occasions, and he has the gamemanship to be able to go out there and
figure it out,
right? I mean, there's great
gold
athletes.
Gold medal on the limp.
Yeah, I mean, there's athletes to the game, and there's great fighters, and then there's a different level where it's like, okay, this is what you do well.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not gonna give you I'm not gonna put you where you're strong at. To where I believe Figueredo, he has the elements of the power. He can grapple. He has good conditioning. But he goes about his fights different. He uses a lot of his power. You know,
he relies on the power.
He's not smooth and moving and popping.
No, he's literally
walking forward. Where Terminator. It's like there's takedown. I mean, I can just break down analysis like that. Where I feel like Henry Cejudo can have that mindset when he fights him.
Yeah, and I think looking at that like super fight, if that were to ever happen, it's like, man, he there'd be some trouble for him against a guy like you. You know, flat-footed guy. You know, but he just. I think he was perfect for the division. I don't mean to make this about the UFC. I just think that division is so interesting with Figueredo now because no one, you know, when you were fighting, the division was great, and then you leave, and they were going to get rid of it.
Yeah.
And then Figueredo comes, he's knocking dudes out, and it's exactly what they needed.
Yeah, and I think that's what they need. I mean, you look at he's knocking dudes out. I'm submitting people, throwing people in the air, catch them in the arm bar and all that stuff, finishing people. So we're both finishing people. It's all going to be down to is it, you know, the casual fan to catch on, right? Because the hardcore fans are going to watch the fight. They're going to figure a way to get it, whether it's, you know, going behind the scenes or it's always about are they going to generate enough pay-per-view buys in order to justify it, right?
Correct.
Because it wasn't like when I was there, I was going to the decisions, like I was finishing
I was starching
people, right? And so it's the same thing, and he's just doing it in a different fashion.
Yeah, and it's gaining traction.